from London, this is Strictly It Takes Two. Please welcome your host, Zoe Ball.
Welcome to It Takes Two. The weekend is still fresh in our minds, but that is not to say we haven't got one eye on this Saturday's Movie Week special. And like a showbiz reporter on the red carpet, we'll be bringing you some juicy exclusives to get you in the mood. But first, shall we see who's in our green room tonight? A splendid bunch. They survived the dance-off and are here to tell the tale. Brian and Amy! It's the flapper and her friend, Ruth and Anton. Oh, lovely bit of sparkle there. And just call her Tallulah, Molly and AJ. Plus, back for more Choreography Corner, it's Joanne Clifton. But first, we're going back to the 70s. On Saturday night, they turned the Strictly Ballroom into their own personal disco. Shake Your Groove Thing. It's Brian and Amy.
Lively, it's bright, it was confident, it had attitude.
The timing was out, there was no hip action, I thought it was very stompy, I'm afraid.
If this competition was just built on entertainment, you would have to be a front runner.
Brian and Amy! She's worked on the wave.
You've worked on the wave.
Oh, I like the old one. I have to say, we heard Shirley say there, if this show was built on entertainment, you would be a front runner.
Oh, thank you, but sadly it's not, is it? It's a dancing show, so...
But you're still here, Brian.
No, but it is mixed blessings. Saying goodbye to Chizzy. She's such a lovely lady. And that's how we felt. We felt like, oh, we're through and... Oh, poor old Chizzy. You know, it really was quite a moving... And you were very...
I was quite emotional.
I went really
numb, I did.
Bless you. Well, it's your first year. You don't want to go out at this point, do you? You know, and that's the great thing. You got to stay. But when you were waiting for, you know, with that music's going off, and I've been there, it's absolutely terrifying. Your little face, I could sort of see you whispering to each other. Were you thinking Dance Off was coming?
Yes, we were.
Okay.
And then when we watched it, I tell you, yeah, don't worry, love, don't worry. Typical sort of, I don't know, Cockney Barrow boy. Yeah, don't worry, love, I've got this. You know, what can I do? You know, you're the professional. But, you could feel my heart, couldn't you?
I could feel his heart behind when we were waiting for the judges to decide. His heart was doing this behind.
It doesn't comes out of your ribcage. You are not.
I do not want to be in one of those dances. I know I'm going to have to, but it's not good for my health.
Oh,
so please vote, ladies and gentlemen, because I'm dying here.
I have to say, though, Darcy was so spectacularly impressed with part of your dance, which was the moonwalk. Mm. We wanted to prove to people watching at home that it was not a trick of the lights or cameras. Would you just give us a little...
I would be delighted.
Yes. Come on,
Brian. I just say, a lot of people say, how did I perfect the moonwalk? Well, what happened? I was walking the dogs and I trod in some doggy poo.
Oh, no.
And I couldn't get it off my foot. Yeah. So that's what I... And then, God, I can moonwalk. You know what I mean? And that's how it came about.
Well, an unfortunate way of discovering, but brilliant for all of us. Okay.
Well, here we go, ladies.
Has anyone got a dog? Here we go.
Are we ready? Here we go. So you got.
I'm Brian.
Oh, the moonwalk does not walk when you cut. Well, when you cut away, you've got to do. Keep on that shot. Here we go.
Nice
ready?
And close up.
No, not my feet. Here you go. That's the moonwalk.
Oh.
Oh,
dear.
Check one, two, one, two, check one, two. Yeah,
there we go. Oh, thank goodness for that. The scores have gone up, though. The scores have gone up. So, better dancer. Yes, already.
Yeah.
Amy, happy.
That's all you can ask for is every week for there to be an improvement. And with the scores, we were so happy, wasn't we?
Yeah.
We had a six.
You're six, I know.
I know, which is three more than what Craig gave us.
Yes,
so we were delighted with that.
We went outside and, you know, afterwards, and you go into the corridor and we were jumping up and down. It was like we won.
But very, a very moving moment, because Amy went, we got six, which is more than a five.
And you're like, well, she's clever.
She's good, this
girl. She is working you incredibly hard in the training room, though, because she is a taskmaster, okay? Here she is, the Welsh dragon, in the training room. Have a look.
Oops. And a cha-cha-cha. Walk, walk, one. Oh! That was a naughty arm.
Amy puts the strict into strictly.
Next time you do a naughty arm, there's going to be a forfeit.
I thought she was going to be nice.
Stand up tall. Two, three.
She keeps shouting at me.
Get low, low, low.
Well, I've got
low,
blood coming low, at my ears because she's so loud.
Low, low, pow, out, step, up.
Oh, my goodness me. Face now. She doesn't look capable of it.
No, no.
Okay.
You know, you don't become a world champion. All right.
British champion. Oh, you see it wrong.
This is sounds better. World
the
champion.
World, that's fine.
I am one of the greatest entertainers in my price range. So, you know, that's what you got to say. But you don't become that if you are not, what's the word, sort of dedicated.
Yes.
And that's what she is. And yeah, I
and
have to take that on board. And we
strict.
Are. Put the strict into strictly.
Exactly, and it's working for you. Okay, so it's movie week and you've got an American Smooth. What's the film?
So we are doing an American Smooth to The Wizard of Oz, and it's If I Only Had a Brain.
Oh,
yes!
A scarecrow!
Yeah, but people have got James Bond bits and sort of Buzz Lightyear, and I've got If I Only Had a Brain. What are they trying to tell me? You know?
And are you going to be like on a thing with the straw?
I've been working on my arms. Should I do my arms for you?
Oh, yeah, come on then. Come on then.
So you've got to have your scarecrow.
Whole day of training today, like that. And yeah.
Scarecrow on.
And then what does that go into?
Well, it goes into jazz splits. That's all I can do. I can only do that. So I'm just going to wander around. No, there's a lot more to it, isn't there?
There is a lot more. And also, week one, he came out and he was tango. So serious, dynamic, totally what Brian isn't. Week two, we come out for entertainment, fun, cheeky, really showed off his personality. And now this week, I would like to show a different side again to Brian, and it to have finesse, style, quality.
Oh, she's a good lass. Good luck this weekend.
Oh, we're looking
the
forward
scarecrow.
To it.
Hope
really
you find your brain. Brian and Amy.
Oh, thank you very much.
Love that. Love that. OK, film fans, fasten your seatbelts because we're about to preview some of the hits on this weekend's soundtrack. It's time for your movie week, Choose on Tuesday. Jukebox, rarely cast in the lead role, but often the scene stealer. Just take that famous pottery scene in Ghost. I couldn't take my eyes off it. And tonight is no different. Let's premiere this weekend's songs, Jukebox, Do Your Thing. Yes! It's Danger Zone from Top Gun by 80s hitmaker Kenny Loggins. Hello, Captain. Believe it or not, Top Gun was released on this very day in the UK 31 years ago. Well, did they not have their tops off when they did this in the film? The role of Maverick may have been career-defining for Tom Cruise, but amongst those considered for the part were Sean Penn, Nicolas Cage, Michael J. Fox, and Tom Hanks. I don't know about you, but it's doing it for me. Who will be dancing to this? You're right there. You're right there, Cougar. I feel the need for speed. Couple, reveal yourself.
Whoa!
Brendan and Charlotte, is he going to win a motorbike? Can you even imagine? They'll be doing a tango to that.
Oh.
We like? Yeah, thanks very much, gentlemen.
I'm just stunned that anybody's accepted Brendan could be Tom
what,
Cruise.
Tom Cruise? Oh. Use your imagination.
Could it be Goose?
It could be Goose. Go on, off you go. You go that way. Thank you very
goose.
Much. Speaking of Goose. Right, what's next on the track list? Here we go. I Can't Stop the Feeling from the 26th animated musical Trolls. Oh, look at them. And if you remember Trolls Dolls the first time round, you were probably alive in the 60s when the whimsical little creatures first became popular. This track was an instant smash for Justin Timberlake, who had a starring role in the movie. We're loving it, ladies, we're loving it. Voicing a troll called Branch. So which of our couples will be trying to impress the judges with this modern classic? Here we go. Doing a cha-cha-cha to that. Thank you, little trolls. Okay, we've got time for one more. Here we go. Yes! Thank you very much. It is, of course, Staying Alive by by the Bee Gees. Could they not get that jacket in your size?
No.
And the second single taken from the soundtrack to Saturday Night Fever, the definitive disco movie. Here's a more curious fact for you. There is medical research that suggests that staying alive has almost the perfect rhythm to help jumpstart a stopped heart. This is a fact. Thank you very much, Brian. Who will be hoping to win the judges' hearts with this number? Today, what is he doing? Let's find out. We'll be doing a samba to that. Oh. Yes, of course. Okay, and together, people. To find out the rest of the songs, head to the Strictly website. Now, my next guest recreated the Roaring Twenties on Saturday night with a cheeky Charleston, and we flapping loved it. It's Ruth and Anton.
Idea, you were such a good flapper.
This dance needs 80% more energy than you gave that.
You had solo pieces, you stayed on time, 100% better this week.
Catherine Zeta-Jones out there, Ruth and Anton. Did you know, I love the wig, we love the frock, and you were such a fantastic flapper. Did you love it? Was it a delight?
I loved the Charleston. Yes. I loved the Charleston. My granny taught me the Charleston step. So when Anton said, we've got the Charleston, I said, oh, I know how to do that. Yeah. My granny taught me that.
I love the fact
just couldn't do the other bit.
You just called him Eamon.
Yeah, Eamon. Yeah. Yeah. Melding into one.
It's not the other way around. That could be awkward.
I'd love to be there for that moment.
But you did it so brilliantly. And also, the other thing was that nobody knows that you had hamstring injury on Friday, so you couldn't rehearse.
Yeah, I'm still strapped up.
No,
I felt I felt very on the back foot, actually, because I felt I hadn't performed. I know I knew the routine.
Mm. Yeah.
But I hadn't been out and done the BAM, yeah. So I had to do everything kind of half measures, hadn't I, to walk it through.
And Shirley was so impressed, Anton, with Ruth doing her solo bits. You obviously felt confidence. There she was, out there alone. It was great.
Scary. I had every confidence in Ruth because when Ruth said, oh, I can do this bit, and I went, hello, that's only the proper bit of Charleston. We'll have some of that. So when she was there on her own doing proper Charleston, beautiful swivels, I was happy as Larry, really. And so it was just that moment where we had the fountain between us, and I thought, I wonder if she can't see me. So I just whizzed down early and then came down, and we were away. It was great.
Then I was thinking, where is he? Is this a joke? He's leaving me up here on my own.
Shall I? No, but I better.
Oh, yeah, a couple of weeks, you wait. I mean, the thing is, your scores have gone up. This is what we want.
Yes.
Week 2, 16 to 20.
For 2 weeks, I think we have gone up. Yes.
You have gone up, thank goodness. But you must be quite thrilled about that.
Oh, yeah. Yes, I mean, nobody wants to be in the bottom. It's horrible being in the bottom. And to hear people say, you know, a great improvement, that's what you want. That's what I'm here to do, is to learn to dance and hopefully get better each week.
I know, fantastic. We're also loving the looks and the transformations of Ruth as we go. Week 1, here you are, with the lovely ponytail.
Sharon from EastEnders. Sharon, it's serious,
and
isn't it?
Week 2, who are you week 2 then?
I was Thoroughly Modern Millie, I think.
Oh,
yes,
great.
Very.
Yeah. So, movie week,
yes.
You are dancing to Bond music. Mm-hmm. Is it Diamonds Are Forever?
Diamonds Are Forever.
So, could this be the look for you for this weekend?
I look like my mum. My mum's a redhead.
Is she?
Gosh, I look like my mum.
No, is she? Now that I think, is it Jill? What was her name?
Jill St. John.
Tiffany Case, she played. But you're not going for that look, are you?
Because I really want long hair. Am I allowed long hair? Because I've never had long hair.
Have it, because we can use hairography.
Oh,
a bit of that.
Yes, because
you give it all that swishing.
The first.
Look
at that.
Do that again.
That rumba.
I wonder if I can make that one last about 35 seconds. Do that again.
This is the first rumba of the series. Are you excited about being the one? You're going to set the bar.
I'm slightly frightened about the rumba. I think it's quite hard.
Yes.
Because it's very slow, so every single movement is noticed. And you have to stick your bottom out in a most peculiar way, and you have to walk forward with slidey feet.
You don't. I just asked you to do that for my own personal
entertainment. Oh, my goodness me. I'm thinking, like, Eamon was quite excited about that wig last week. This week you're doing a rumba.
I'm hoping to bring a wig home every weekend, Zoe.
Oh, it's amazing.
for as long as I stay.
Oh, we've got some delights, believe me, Ruth.
Man,
and what is it? What's the key to a rumba? What are we looking for? Because this, you know, sometimes it's romantic, sometimes it's
I'm not one for the sort of ooh, a sexy rumba.
Shame.
Well, I mean, fill your boots if you fancy, but I like an intense moment. I think it's got to be intense, and it's got to be stylish, and then it can be anything from that moment in time. And our rumba is going to be like that. It's going to be intense because I want Ruth to be able to perform it without having to do any sort of gurning and sort of chewing the lemon sherbet.
I said to him, don't say look sexy, because if I try and pout, I look like I'm stuck in a sherbet lemon.
Frankly, it might just be me, but I've never wanted a more.
Good luck, my gorgeous Bond girl.
Enjoy.
Love the two of you. Ruth and Anton.
Oh, dear.